MTV's Partyzone is sponsored by Sony.
Welcome to the Party Zone. A bit of a busy show tonight. We've got a double bill. The second hour, I'll be talking to Patrick Prince. And the first hour, with me, Alam.
Yeah.
Welcome Hello. To the show.
Hello.
Right, one quick thing, let's get it out of the way right now. How did you guys meet?
No.
I was talking to a DJ friend of mine, and I'd been trying to find somebody to work with on music for a while, and he mentioned Andy, who'd been working in a studio with working with DJs, writing tunes and stuff. And he said, Andy's a bit weird for us, but you might get on with him. And so I found
he did
him
house
out
music.
Of the blue.
It was very, very sort of conventional, sort of fall to the floor.
Oh, that's not fair on him.
Well, it was pretty conventional, and I was trying to give it an alternative twist, a bit of a tangent, and they. Like weirdness wasn't fashionable at that time.
I know. So. I heard you got a fight or something for being too weird.
Yeah,
but that's a compliment, you know. Yeah, you know when someone says that, you know you're going to do well. Mm. You know, basically. So what happened? So you guys met. You started singing for him, and it was like
we no, just. Oh, that is the worst thing she could have said. Did you hear that? She started singing for him.
No, I mean,
that's
you did.
Really,
did you?
No.
How do you mean? Excuse me.
Well, it wasn't really like she started singing for me. It was more like
we played each other demos, basically,
right.
And sussed out. Well, I don't think either of us were particularly enamoured with each other's demos, but we just could see something in what the other had done that we could, you know, it was just there was a spark or something there. We kind of knew that we could do something together and. It wasn't as if we sat down and said we want to write this sort of music or that sort of music. We just went into a studio when basically Andy had some free studio time and we wrote our first song, which was God Bless. I mean, an earlier version of God Bless, but that was the first tune we wrote together with very little pre-planning or anything. And
so we just, from the first tune, we just knew that that was it. You know, we'd found someone.
Yeah.
We're really excited. You know, you could feel it and it was really strong. So
if that was the first track you recorded and it's, you know, it's still here now, I mean, all the tracks you've done, are they all on the album or have you guys, like, recorded loads of stuff?
I think we've only got about 3 songs that we've ever done that haven't been released.
Yeah, it wasn't a case
of... pretty slowly as well. Usually if a song gets to completion, it's good enough in our minds to go out.
Yeah.
If it's not, then we'll just give up on it and, you know, try another angle.
So, and what about, because you were on the Skin label before, how did you guys ended up on Mercury? How come you guys didn't sign Skinned?
I mean, Skin were sort of offering...
We were talking to them for a while.
At the time, there was a few things going around, and it was like, oh, an independent, yeah, that would be really good. But to actually sort of, you know, do the live show that we do, and to sort of... I think Lamb, it does need, like, the cooperation of an understanding, quote, major.
It was also about, you know, the thing is that with Lamb, we've never had any rigid framework of what, well, we're going to do this, we're going to sign to a label like this, you know. It's just basically kind of, we allow ourselves to be open to follow, you know, we did like the idea of signing to an independent at first, but then we met our A&R man, Richard O'Donovan, and we were very sceptical when he first came up. You know, it was a major record label, we were like,
He didn't show up.
Yeah, the day before that,
over the phone as well. So.
But then we met him, and it was just, the vibe was right, you know. It was just straight away, the vibe was right with him, and... You know, we had our reservations, but we just tend to kind of go for if the vibe's right with people.
Exactly.
You know,
if the feeling's right, you're going to go with it.
And
if
they've been touch wood, they've been really good so far. They've given us, from the word go, we made it clear that even though we were signing with a major, we wanted to keep our own creative freedom. And that goes as far as organising our own photo shoots, video shoots. We work closely with the director.
Cool.
And like we all,
and
you know,
cover design,
produce,
everything comes through us. So,
well, listen, well, you know, we've been talking quite a lot. For all you people out there, if you still don't know who Lamb are, I mean, you've been hearing them talk. Let's go and watch a video just to kind of educate you. Here's Cotton Wool.
Here's my love. Step inside. Let me warm you up by the fire in my heart. Step inside, close the door on the wind of fear brewing up behind you. You could stay. Thank you.
Some more news just in. This... excuse me. This Saturday, MTV is going live with the best of Live and Loud. The best unplugs. Therapy and guests, live and direct, and live unplugged. That's Live Day. Today. And now, for the weather report. There are I.
Presenting the Sony Recordable Mini Disc. The only disc that lets you record any track you want and play it back in digital quality sound. Why not record one of your own before you hit the road? Got yours yet? The Sony Recordable Mini Disc.
every day as if it were your last. Johnny Walker Red Label. Taste life.
Quickfinder, so schnell. Ein Kniff, ein Griff und schon das richtige Programm.
TV Movie, 14 Tage schneller finden, was sich lohnt. Jetzt mit Quickfinder.
Einfach antesten.
Ask anyone to draw a star. Most of the time, you'll see this. Perceptions can be misleading. It's time to take a good look at the new Hyundai, where reality exceeds expectations. Hyundai.
I'm always petrified of the first kiss, because I know it could make or break my life. And I'm almost always disappointed. Not because I don't like kissing, because I like kissing. Kissing's good. It's just I only like it with one out of a million girls. So what I do is I try, I fail, I try, fail, try, I fail.
Be choosy, be chosen, just be.
CKB, the fragrance for people, Calvin Klein.
Look carefully at these ice cubes. Do you see a subliminal message? Do you see a beautiful naked woman smiling seductively at you? If you do, you probably just need a girlfriend.
Partyzone with Lamb. Now, you guys just done a big London gig, and I am so gutted. I didn't actually get to see it. I only just found out.
With a boyfriend.
I know, I didn't know. I should have known, but I didn't know. And I just heard absolute rave reviews. Everyone's just been blown away by it. Are you guys
buzzing? We were blown away by the audience.
We were buzzing, definitely. Yeah. We had a string section there and loads of friends and just, it's one of those gigs, like, first note, double bass, everyone just sort of went mad, and it was like, it's going to be a good gig.
Mm. It was lots of really lovely smiling faces and, you know, that I could see in the crowd, and it was just like, yeah, you know.
And the people singing along and stuff.
So what about with your music, either live or on record, what do you hope your music does for people? What are you trying to do with your music?
Just write music that we want to write.
Yeah, express our sort of emotions that are from, you know, in us, and kind of put them into speaker waves that other people can hear.
You can't really predict how people are going to receive your music, or, you know, that's not really our job. Our job is to make the music that comes from within, you know. It's not about structuring it for a certain group of people or anything like that. It's just about us, you know. And the bonus is that when you play it live, you get to see what people's response is, and then that's the biggest buzz, you know, because you're just getting feedback straight away from a crowd of people, and, you know, mostly it's been really good feedback as well, so. Yeah.
So what about the lyrics? Is there any one of you that does the lyrics, or?
Lou's in charge of lyrics.
Right. So what about the lyrics? I mean, what, are they very personal? Are they, do you know, is there different meanings within them? That, you know, when you like see a painting and you don't know what the painter is really trying to say, and then when you hear the explanation, you go, wow. Is that what happens with your music, or are you quite direct with your lyrics?
A bit of both, really. Mm. I mean, it's good that you compare it to painting in a way, because the paintings or the art that I love the most is art that asks more questions than gives answers. You know, it's not obvious, it's not, you know, it's kind of abstract or whatever, and you're drawn to it because you're kind of intrigued by it. And the lyrics are very personal, but they don't say things very obviously a lot of the time, so they might need people to listen a little bit more carefully. But I mean, they are hideously personal, most of them, and it's not a case of, I don't really sit down and think, I'm going to write about this today. I just, you know, they come from within whenever. They, you know, if I'm driving my car or doing the washing up or whatever, you know, they just happen with what's going on in my mind, or if a melody comes into my mind or whatever, you know.
and that's totally so. How does it work with you? Do you completely do the music side of the lyrics, or does it all blend in?
With the lyrics, it's pretty much Lou's shout. Yeah. But we compare it to, with breakbeats, I'm a doctor and Lou's a nurse. Right. I'm a doctor and nurses. And in the emotions department,
and you get paid.
I'm just the doorkeeper in the emotions department.
Emergency, there's a horse in the hospital.
So what about because you guys, you know, are big on remixing and stuff as well. Do you think that actually takes away?
I think it is totally an art form. You know,
right.
You're going to say if it takes away from the track or adds to the track. But I mean, with some bands, it's obvious in their remixing that they're actually getting cool people to actually sell the record. And you know, for us, it's people who we think will either add something or take something away, but change it and give their, you know, it's the label aren't watching, I'm sure, but it's not a commercial consideration when we ask for remixes. That's why we're not getting Vasquez mixes and house mixes. And
I don't think it would work.
No.
Yeah, but I mean, there have been cases like that, you know, of names we won't mention who have had, you know, drum and bass production and then a Todd Terry remix, you know.
It's not real.
You've got to stay true to yourselves. And for us, it's always the point of getting a remix isn't the marketing perspective, which for a lot of people it is. It's just a case of getting people whose work we really respect and whose work has inspired us, maybe, and handing a track back to them, kind of thing. And it's just really exciting to see
mix
what they'll do.
And creativity. Yeah. Anyway, let's. Sorry.
It's almost like a selfish thing, like. What would they do with this? You know, these people who we respect, like when Philip Brazilian, they cut on wall, we got it back. And
it's like Christmas unwrapping your presents.
And the feeling that you get, and you're like, you know, they're my ingredients that cook has rearranged in his, like, way, but it's, you know, it's a meal, but it's...
It tastes different. Anyway, we're going to go and watch another video again. Now, this was the first track you guys recorded, but naturally...
The first one we wrote. This is
the first one you wrote.
Very much later version.
Okay, it's a later version. God bless.
You're gonna feel the wind at your heels, you know. You're gonna feel a sparkle in your step. Everything will touch you in a different way, yeah. Let it come, soon come, let it come. 'Cause I'm gonna make you feel lighter than the air above. Let me breathe it into you. Let me breathe it into you. Let me breathe it into you. Keep this precious thing. Gotta keep it going.
Today's photographic memory is our featured CD of the week. It's a double CD, actually, and it's a double CD dedicated to Sally Harding, who was a photographer for Volume. She sadly died in end of 95, and basically this shows a lot of her work, a lot of the stuff she's done. She made some insane pictures of people like, you know, the Drum Club, and what was it, Orbital is in there.
Primal Scream.
Pictures from the Love Parade. That's a good one.
That's funny, that.
That's
one.
A good picture. I like that. And so this, it's got tracks on here from, let me see, Drum Club, Spooky, Banco de Gaia, Mead Be Benefesto, Orbital, Ultramarine. Loads and loads of stuff. So definitely get hold of this one, Sally's photographic memory. Now, Lou, you were a photographer yourself, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
You were.
Yeah, in fact, I did some work for Volume magazine. So, but I never met Sally, unfortunately.
You never met Sally. Were you familiar with her work?
Yeah. I remember seeing it.
So, I mean, with you guys, you guys said you definitely take charge a lot when it comes to pictures and artwork and stuff. Is it because of your background that you feel that you know enough about it?
Yeah, and also that it's important, you know. But it's another aspect of, you know, if you sign to a major record label, there's a danger of losing your identity a little bit in the sort of huge mechanisms that they have, you know. If you just leave it to them, you know, it's a bit of a risky business, so... Yeah. You know, it's always been because, and yeah, I suppose because I come from a sort of visual arts background in a way, it's kind of important to me, and also I'm in a position to be able to do it, you know. So, I mean, I don't take our press photos because it's difficult to do when you're in them, but we work closely with
quickly you're on with the timer.
You could do, but you know, you never get the right sort of.
It can get quite fraught, sort of, photographers off camera, sort of, and Lou. And it is really annoying when you go to a brilliant location and get, you know, all the perfect conditions, and then you see the picture in NME or something, and it looks like a snapshot.
You have got to
take control. You've got, you know, put your foot down and say you can't do it.
So was it a conscious decision to not have your picture on the CD sleeve?
Yeah. I mean, this photo's inside.
Yeah.
Again, we weren't too bothered about having our photos inside, but it was kind of a little bit of a compromise with the record company. But yeah, I think it's pretty corny having band photos on the front of us.
Reminds me of people like Duran Duran or something. Yeah. You know, when they all dolled them.
It's usually heavy metal bands who have the pictures on the front of record covers. Or the Spice Girls.
Gosh, just Spice Girls. Let's not start talking about them. Anyway, I'd like one of you two to choose a favourite video. So who wants to do it?
Do you want to do the autocall one?
Yeah, this one was the guy who directed it. We still don't know.
Chris something. We can't remember his name, brilliant, but he's brilliant.
He worked with some aliens videos, and he sort of built this robot for the Autechra tune, and it just fits perfectly. So it's
we got it on the show.
Absolutely
clicked
what video it is.
Yeah.
It is insane. It
builds itself in the static. Yeah.
Cool.
With all the TV interference and everything.
Cool. So we're going to watch that right now.
Yeah.
Here it is.
Bible. Thank you.
abgebissen, abgeschmiert.
Fünf Plätze rauf.
Steigt und steigt und steigt nach unten gefallen.
Nach unten.
Standhaft. Wow, European Top 20, die steilsten Charts weit und breit. Mittwochs um 1, samstags um 11 und sonntags um 6 Uhr nur auf MTV.
I've met a few.
This symbol is a legend. The legend of Champion USA, defining the history of American sports since 1919. Champion USA. Authentic athletic clothing. The choice of American sport for more than 75 years. Champion USA. It takes a little more to make a champion.
Max bringt die CD mit 18 Top-Hits zum großen Musikreport. Lauterbach-Freundin Jenny Elvers, Bill Gates und sein Hightech-Palast, die Supermodels des Santa Doratio. Alle Szene-Tipps im City Guide New York. Alles in Max, jetzt am Kiosk.
If it were your last. Johnny Walker Red Label. Taste life.
It's taking over our world. And now it's coming to your home. Independence Day.
Now what do we do?
Why Independence Day on video.
I have got to get me one of these!
Before it's too late.
Time's up.
Quickfinder, genial einfach. Ein Kniff, ein Griff und schon bin ich im richtigen Programm.
TV-Movie, 14 Tage schneller finden, was sich lohnt. Jetzt mit Quickfinder.
Ausprobieren.
Capture the moment, take the picture.
Warum Diäten nichts bringen, warum man in Fitnessstudios nicht abnimmt, warum Wundermittel gefährlich sind. Amika sagt Ihnen, was andere verschweigen. Amika, jetzt für 5 Mark am Kiosk.
Watching Partyzone with Lam. I just want to tell you a few strange facts about Lam.
Strange
facts. One is that Andy puts nail varnish on every time he's in a mad situation, people got nail varnish, he will put a colour on each nail to remember.
Remind myself of the gig or the TV show or whatever I was doing. I've got a better one than that though.
What is that?
I enjoy making parcels out of people's ears. Like if you get the lobe and sort of turn them all in. In fact, it inspired the most recent of the tunes, ear parcels. Yeah.
Well,
have
I can got... put it in. I've got a very
She's
big
got lobes.
Ear lobe.
You've got big lobes.
And they...
Yeah, that's not bad.
Ow. And the other one is that he dries. I've just been learning about washing as well, and he dries his
smalls
in the dressing room. So if you ever come to a dram
nice.
Dressing room,
it's
you
not
know,
nice.
You know what to expect.
At least they're clean.
Okay.
You haven't got any weird facts on me.
Clean and wet. No, I haven't got any on you, really. Apart from that, you've got a chest infection and you're still here. Now, that is rock
and roll. Hey.
That is rock and roll. The lady just keeps going. What else are we going to ask you guys? Yeah, about your music. I heard that you like to describe your music as futuristic jazz.
Future
right?
jazz.
Mm. Future jazz.
If
yes.
we have to.
Right,
if we
okay.
We have to categorize it.
Okay. Yeah, that's the broadest one we could come up with.
Okay.
We don't really like putting it into a category, but we found that if we didn't, somebody else would.
Oh, yeah.
Call it something terrible like trip-hop
or drum and bass, which it just isn't.
It definitely takes influences from all their scenes. Do you actually, because I've heard people who heard the album and said, oh, it's really brilliant, but they've come at such a bad time, because now straight away people will say that they've jumped on a, either drum and bass bandwagon or on a trip-hop bandwagon. Do you feel that at all?
No. They can if they actually listen to us, then they'll realise they're talking a load of absolute beep.
Right.
So, you know,
nonsense.
I mean, I don't like labels, but it's kind of understandable that, like, someone's gone to a gig and they go, so what was it like? You kind of have to give them, because you can't...
Yeah, but there's so many other ways of describing our music than, you know, resorting to these comparisons, you know? Yeah. I mean, it's a whole... There's so many influences in there. And, yeah, drum and bass is one, hip-hop's one, soul music's one, techno's one, classical music's one. Do you know what I mean? We are... Every band's a product of its... environment, you know. We're not jumping on any bandwagon. We were listening to breakbeat when it first started. Do you know what I mean? There's a lot of other people you could level that criticism at, but not us, you know.
And Cotton Wool was, for my money, one of the first breakbeat song that I mean, with their production, the vocals in the middle, and the rest of the music wraps it around.
Yeah.
A lot of people will do sort of drum and bass production with a song on the top of it, like icing.
Yeah.
It won't actually sit in
thing.
It. As is, you know, we just both chip away at the block so we can get the thing to sort of... Yeah.
And the thing is, when you listen to the album, you know, basically the way we produce our tracks is that we give them the production that's relevant, so some tracks without any drums at all. How can people say we're jumping on a drum and bass bandwagon, you know? It's, we are what we are, we are Lamb.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? You don't need any...
But I think things like last night's performance will definitely set things like that straight, because what I've heard is, like, you know, I've asked people, describe it, and no one's been able to, so I'm sure that with things like that, you'll definitely set the record straight. Something completely different again, Hold on, you've just chosen a video, so Luge, your turn. I can't get my words out. You do it for me.
It's got to be A Tribe Called Quest, and I left my wallet in El Segundo.
I gotta get it.
Right, we're nearly halfway through the show, and nearly the end of my interview with Lamb. It's quite a mad show, by the way, because later I'm going to have Patrick Prince on, so also make sure you stay tuned for that. Now with you guys, what is going to happen next?
Go on holiday.
Yeah.
Write an album in Thailand.
We're back in the studio in Manchester, actually, not in Thailand.
Right. Oh, not tropical.
Oh, let me daydream.
Totally topical and tropical.
Music. We haven't written any for ages, we've just been touring, so...
And it's all sticking in our heads, you know, it's just got to be, kind of, get out.
Have you got loads of ideas?
Yeah, definitely. No, we really need to get in the studio.
Oozing with ideas at the moment.
So this summer, we're not going to see you at festivals and things like that?
Oh, yeah, no, during summer. I just want to go out and have fun. Like, and it's sat in a cold, dark studio, it's just... Not in summer.
We've got to do a bit of both, really. Mm. We can't be in the studio all the time, especially in the summer.
No, I mean, you can't miss all the festivals. There's so much fun.
We've got some confirmed already, I think.
Oh, really?
What's that?
We're doing that tribal gathering.
And there's a Dutch one, something pop?
Pink pop.
Yeah, we're doing that.
That's confirmed, I think. And
we'll be played.
We're keeping our fingers crossed for Glastonbury. But
day before Glastonbury, us a massive attack.
Well, that's not confirmed.
It's not confirmed, but if it happens, then...
That'd be very good. Well, we'll keep our fingers crossed and see what happens. Now, before you guys leave me, can you kind of educate me a little bit about this? Was it Goreski? Okay, I'm an MTV girl. I don't know about Goreski.
Goreski.
Go on then.
An
airhead.
He's a Polish composer, contemporary Polish composer, and he wrote, amongst other things, Symphony No. 3, Symphony of Sorrowful Songs, which partially inspired our track, Goreski. The Symphony of Sorrowful Songs is probably one of the most moving classical pieces I've ever heard.
So are you guys classically trained in any?
No, you're not.
We blag it, we wing it.
Right, okay.
Absolutely not, but hey, you can appreciate it, you know.
Well, we get string sections in and they say, who's doing the arrangement? We are. Okay, what's the score? Oh, we haven't got it. Can you just make this bit a bit more orange? And can you twist this bit? And I want a corkscrew noise here.
In Goreski, we actually had the Chainsaw Sisters, the two cellists that played on the album. And we got them to record various strings and then, you know, layered them up to sound like a sort of orchestral kind of thing. And we had to just sing the parts to them, really. And they were going, is that E flat? And it was like, I don't know.
We didn't realise you needed a string arranger. We just thought the strings arrived, and we didn't know really how it worked.
But I think sometimes musical knowledge can get in the way of improvisation and experimentation. And I think in a way it's quite good that we're neither of us are particularly highly qualified in any one instrument or whatever. It's just we feel the music rather than actually knowing it, you know. And
it's got a freshness.
Yes. Mm. Our mistakes are quite often our most creative moments.
Yeah. Well, I hope you're going to make loads of mistakes over the next few weeks. Anyway, thanks so much for being in the show.
Thank you.
That was cool. And next time you guys play, I have to go.
Absolutely.
Do you know what I mean? There's just no way I'm going to miss
that again. We'll be looking for you in the audience.
I know. I will be there.
You get your limo.
Yes, get me my limo. Anyway, let's go and watch Goreski now. And normally I would say goodbye now, but stay tuned because there's more coming in just a minute. Me and Patrick Prince, stay tuned for that.
If I should die this very moment, I wouldn't fear. For I've never known completeness. Wrapped in the warmth of you, loving every breath of you, still my heart this moment.